A little while ago, I mentioned that electricity and magnetism is a lot like magic. And in this video, I'm going to prove it to you. So let's prove it with an actual magic wand. And if you could go to the slide that says, what explains the sorcery of repelling and attracting charges and how did we discover it? You're going to see three squares on there with little rods like this that are having an effect on each other due to electric forces. In one case, there's repelling. In one case, there's attracting. In one case, there's picking up some paper. And I want to explore these electric effects with my own wand and this wool right here. Okay, so I'm going to rub this wool on this wand. Okay, and I'm going to lean back here. I'm going to get close to this aluminum foil, and I want you to see what happens. Ooh, what happened there? It was actually attracted. If I go over here on this side, same thing. We have an attraction happening right here, right? It's almost magic. I'm making this thing move by itself, all right? And as we can see, there was an actual attractive force, right? At a distance without actual contact. This is cool. What the heck is actually going on here? I'm gonna do my best to kind of explain this with a little drawing. So here's a little rope. Here is the aluminum foil, okay? And it's important to note that aluminum foil is a conductor. That means electrons can move freely through it, all right? And so here's my little rod. And you need to know that when I rub this rod with the wool, all right, the wool became positively charged and the rod became negatively charged. How would that happen? How would that happen? Well, what happened was the rod actually pulled electrons. Like, I rubbed electrons onto the rod by rubbing the wool onto it, okay? So if this is a neutral and electrons move onto the rod becomes negative and the wool then becomes positive. This is my wool. And now this is positively charged, right? This doesn't mean that there's like suddenly more protons here. It means the electrons that were around these atoms were stripped off due to friction and put onto this rod, okay? So if this fellow gets close to the aluminum foil here, what do you suppose is gonna happen to this aluminum foil? Well, the electrons that are on this side of the foil, right over here, right? They're gonna see all the electrons over there and they're gonna be like, I don't like that, I repel electrons. So that means all those electrons are gonna get on this side, right? And if all the electrons move, because it's a conductor and it's free to move, if all the electrons move to this side of the foil, that's gonna leave positive charges here, right? This side of the foil is gonna be left a little bit positive, okay? Now, what happens if these positive charges are actually closer to these negative charges? Well, they're gonna be like, oh, I like you electrons. And they're gonna wanna flow over. And so then you get this rocking motion towards it, all right? It's pretty cool. This is called charging by friction, right? I use the friction between this wool and this rod to actually change the charge balance. And now I can have physical effects in the real world. This force between positive and negative charges is actually called Coulomb's law. We're gonna learn about that later in this chapter. But for now, just notice that's what's happening. And that if I wanted to do the same dang thing with a balloon, hopefully this works. Okay. The same thing should happen. Check it out. Oh, attraction, right? So whether or not we're using wool or balloon, it's the same sort of thing. I just rub that balloon. I have a bunch of negative charges and the same phenomenon happens. It polarizes. That's the word where, you know, electrons move to one side and protons are left on the other side. This foil will polarize and then there will actually then be an attraction between the positive charges on this side and the negatively charged balloon, okay? This is the first explanation for why we see the static electric effects that we happen to see in the world, okay? And so the other interesting thing to take away from this is that this was electrically neutral, okay? There was no net charge on here, and still it was affected by the magic wand because the magic wand was charged. And the reason why even neutral things can experience an electric force is because of this polarization. As long as you have one side, right, that's one charge, the other side that's the other charge, but then that positive charge is closer to the negative charges, there's going to be an attraction, okay? All right, if you could go to the next slide, you see this process of charging by friction, where friction actually is pulling apart molecules, right? It's taking electrons off of an atom and actually leaving it as an ion, right? And so you can see kind of like the visual representation of it in this picture. And so one of the lingering questions that I had when I first learned this is, wait a second, how do we know that this ends up being negative? Okay, and how do we know that this ends up being positive? Why couldn't it have been the other way around? Why isn't it that, in fact, what happens is this wool pulled electrons off of the plastic, and now I actually have a positive positive magic wand or a positive rod here, okay? Well, it turns out that based upon the friction of various items, there's something called the triboelectric series. And you guys could see it on this slide that says the triboelectric series. When you rub two things together, what becomes negative and what becomes positive, you can tell based upon this spectrum of items that is listed on this series. You can see at the very top of this triboelectric series, there's the human body, and there's glass, and nylon, and wool. And then at the bottom, there's steel, polyurethane, vinyl, silicon. So basically, the thing that's higher on the triboelectric series will always be the positive thing. And the thing that's lower on the triboelectric series will always get the negative, right? So if I rub wool, you see wool is above polyurethane. That means the wool is going to wind up positive and polyurethane is going to wind up negative, okay? So just a quick, like, think, pair, share, or basically a misconception question. What charges will steel and skin have if you rub them together? So if I take steel, I have a slinky here, and I rub it against my skin, what charges should each be? Well, the human body is at the very, very top of the triboelectric series, which means my body arm will wind up being positive, and the steel, the slinky, will end up being negative. Cool, huh? Now you know. So let's take a look at misconception question number one. Your clothing tends to cling together after going through the dryer. This is another thing that we've all experienced and probably wondered about, never fully understood why, but you probably noticed there's some like clinging and some static when you pull the stuff apart and you get out of the dryer, right? Why does that happen? Would you expect more or less clinging if your clothing were made of the same material, say cotton, than if you dried different kinds of clothing together? Okay, so here's the thing. What is going on in a dryer? Well, you have different stuff that is tumbling all over each other, right? And the tumbling, it's basically just the rubbing, like I did with the wool on the magic wand. So what's gonna happen is, if these are different materials, the triboelectric series says some of them are gonna end up being positive and some are gonna end up being negative. What happens when some materials are positive and negative? Well, they're attracted. And if they're attracted, they're stuck together and you're gonna get that snap, crackle, pop when you pull it apart, okay? What if they were all the same material? Well, if they were all the same material, then they'd be at the same point on the triboelectric series, and there'd be no reason for one to be more positive or negative than the other. And so, what that means is you wouldn't really get that static cling. For those of you who aren't quite sure or want to prove to themselves that this really is a static electric effect that we're seeing when we pull clothing apart that comes out of the dryer, I encourage you all to turn the lights off next time you are pulling out your laundry from the dryer. Turn the lights off and pull it apart right in front of you. You will actually see little mini lightnings jumping from one piece of clothing to the other. Really fun, really cool the first time I saw it. And I hope you had the same reaction. So, in addition to this little demo that I have here. I included in the module two FET demonstrations that kind of just explore different static electric effects as well. One is the effect where you actually shock someone else, right? Why does that happen? Well, it happens because, well, if I'm walking around all day, okay, I am actually gathering electrons by friction, charging by friction my body, right? My net body will be charged. And so if I touch a doorknob or if I touch my little brother, what happens? All those extra charges jump off my body and shock the other person, all right? There's also the effect, if you guys could go to the old party balloon problem. So at least when I was a kid, I don't know how popular this is anymore, but when I was a kid, we would rub balloons on our hair. I can't really do that. But we would rub balloons and we would put them on the wall and they would stay there for a while. Why does that happen? Why is that sticking? Well, it's the same sort of static electric effect that we saw here. And in this demo, which again is in the module, you can check out that effect. You can see why it happens and you explain it for yourself, okay? Please know, very likely on the first exam, there will be some problem that involves explaining why this static electric attraction happens, even for objects that are neutral, like a wall or like a piece of aluminum foil, like this.